What's up, party members? Just the Party 8 here. Welcome back for more LEGO Star Wars: The Complete Saga. Sorry about that. We didn't get a part on Friday, but I was really busy. I said this during Sonic Heroes, but now we're back for more LEGO Star Wars: The Complete Saga. Anyway, in the last episode, we've done the two longest levels in the game, in my opinion: Speeder Showdown and the Battle of Endor. In this episode, I'm going to go over to the last two main levels, and then we'll be finished with story mode, at least. So first off is Chapter 5, Jedi Destiny. Let's get on with this. Chapter 5, Jedi Destiny. As the battle between the Imperial and Rebel forces rages around the second Death Star, Luke Skywalker confronts Darth Vader, his father once Anakin Skywalker, from boy slave on Tatooine to hero of the Clone Wars to Sith Lord. Feared throughout the galaxy, Anakin Skywalker's path has been dark indeed. In front of Emperor Palpatine, his villainous master Vader must now face his son and reclaim his fate. Here he is. Use Thunderbolt! No! That is not how it went in the movie, but okay. Okay, time to fight against the Emperor and look at that health bar. Yeah, this guy has the most health out of any, I think out of any character in any LEGO game. Hey, when he's trying to do lightning, you want to switch characters. And yes, we are playing it with Darth Vader. Hell yeah. Alright. I'm not gonna turn those down, you know, those red things over there. Because that's for a mini kit, and we can skip it. Also, these Imperial guards are very annoying. They're a little bit less annoying in this game because you can just do this. In LEGO Star Wars 2, you cannot do that, I think. Or at least I didn't try. And it's a good time for power up because, you know, a lot of studs. This, you. I once said this, that this was my favorite level in the game, but I don't know. The entire level is basically a boss fight, so it's not entirely. No, let's not do that. I do love the music of this level. The Emperor, as you might, if you guys don't know, is still my favorite villain in all of Star Wars. Some people like Darth Vader as their favorite villain, but to me it's the Emperor. It also includes the one from Episode 9. Because I like the Emperor in Episode 9. A lot of people say that was Ian McDiarmid's, you know, worst time as the Emperor. But to be honest, he did a pretty good job. And I have to agree, he looked pretty terrifying the first time I saw him in Episode 9. Aww. But by even though he has a lot of health, this is one of the absolute easiest battles ever. Also, every 10 seconds, you hear the Emperor laugh, which is kind of annoying. The annoying thing about these Imperial guys is that they have 4 health. They have 4 hearts, just like a regular character. Which is very annoying. And you need a lot of studs for this level, I forgot about that. There we go. Ah! I actually don't know when he said ah in the movie, but probably not. Maybe they added it into this game. Wait, hang on. Oh yeah, I'm playing as Luke, I'm not playing... I hate these guys. Excuse me, thank you. And that was not even fair, come on. I do love their death sound, eh. Alright, so let's get this. Get the thing. I'm gonna show you all the secret rooms later on, of course, when we have other characters. Because there are a lot of secret rooms in this level. That's how of course you can get the mini kits. And wow, we're actually almost done, and we're not even 10 minutes in. And time for the final hit. Final hit of epicness. So let's do this with Darth Vader. Rawr! Oh no! I have to say, the scene is a lot better in this game compared to The Force Awakens. You know, the Lego game. Alright, we got Darth Vader. Which I think is the last character you get for free. And the rest you have to buy. Alright, 50. Let's go to the last level of this game. Which is a vehicle level, of course. This is probably my favorite vehicle level in the entire game. Chapter 6, Into the Death Star. With help from the Ewoks, the rebels have finally managed to destroy the Death Star shield generator on Endor. In the sky above, the Rebel fleet has come under intense fire from Imperial craft and the Death Star itself. Many ships have been destroyed. General Lando Calrissian is now able to lead his final assault on the Empire's ultimate weapon and pilot the Millennium Falcon deep into the Darkheart. Oh, there he is, our favorite fishman. It's a trap! Sorry. Alright, first it's the space part. And we're playing as the Millennium Falcon again, which I have bad memories with. If you remember, episode 5, chapter 3. It's meh. This one is actually not that bad. Or at least the enemies are not that bad, at least. Alright, for this first part you need to destroy the cores of these purple thingies that's above the Star Destroyers. And I'm trying to find a TIE Bomber which has a... which has the purple torpedoes. Ah, there you are. Alright, that's one. You can get the minikits, as you can see right there. There's a minikit right there. But I'm trying my damnedest to avoid it. To avoid them. Let's get this. Thank God I got it. Alright, let's get these. And boom. You don't get a lot of money in the space part, so... in the next part of the level, you're going to get a lot of studs. And ah, dang it. Oh well, these things are very straightforward, these minikits, so yeah. It's alright. I missed all those studs right there. Gimme. Thank you. Give me those last two, come on. Where's the last Star Destroyer? Come on. There you are. And boom. One more? Okay. Let's get oh, never mind. It's no longer a trap! Alright, let's go. Into the Death Star, literally. Okay, let's do this. You can get a lot of studs, but you also gotta watch out for the enemies. Of course, that's obvious. Wow, that's a fantastic start. No, wait. Hearts. Yeah, I'm gonna die. I don't have any freaking hearts. Yep, there we go. It's level 3, episode 5, once all over again. And oh, you suck! Out of the way. Oh, I did not get that stupid. Get the hearts. Oh, I missed it. Oh, there it is. Ah, dang it. That's the annoying thing about this level. The enemies are keep respawning. That's definitely a complaint I have about the vehicle levels in the original trilogy, is that they keep respawning the enemies. It's not the most annoying, it's very annoying. I know it's supposed to be a challenge, but that's just a kind of annoying challenge. Okay, let's get this. Now this part of the level, this level was probably the most jerkish mini kit location ever, or at least to me it is. And screw you, seriously. Okay, let's get this thing. We need to get two of these. Oh no. I think they didn't shoot missiles in the original. Come on, get out. Get out. Thank you. For that, let's get one more torpedo. You cannot hit me. So yeah, after this mission, we're gonna go for the collectibles, and of course, any bonus levels, anything. Aha! Barrel helps. Okay, let's go to the final. Second final parts. Here we need to destroy these things right here that are protecting the core. And leave me alone, seriously. And oh, come on, that's what I get for. I don't care anymore. I just want to finish this story level. And the annoying thing about these things is that they keep paralyzing you if you're getting too close. Get away from me! Thank you. How did I miss that heart? Come on. Get away, please. Go away. I never knew TIE fighters will be so annoying. Just die, thank you. Just die. Get the heart, thank you. Oh my god. Whatever, let's just end this and let's get out of here. Let's get out of here. No. Oh. The game froze there for a second. Alright, for this last part, just keep shooting and do victory. And don't worry about accidentally getting all the minikits in this part. Here you can also get the most money because you know, no enemies. Number 4. And final part. Oh my god. Yes! Yes! True Jedi! Thank you! I never thought that would happen. Also, yeehaw! Sorry, I have to mimic Lando right there with this yeehaw. And the classic yup. I get to say, I will say this after this cutscene. I get to say right now, I think yup. Fits the Lego version of fits Lego Star Wars, and the new victory celebration in the special editions fit the movies more. Cause I have to say, I think Yup Yup fits the Lego games a lot. it's funny because I did not hear that Yup Yup was the actual original movie ending song in the very original Return of the Jedi. Yes, I'm a 2000 kid, so forgive me. And it's Anakin as a ghost. Now let's party. Hey, it's Yoda as well. Well, it was a nice ending. Okay, I'm not gonna ditch out the sequel trilogy because I'm gonna be honest. The sequel trilogy is not as bad as people say, but eh. Not talking about that. I guess that's enough of this episode. We've gone through all the main levels in story modes. One thing is out of the way. So I guess we're gonna say next time on LEGO Star Wars, we'll be going back to square one. And the first thing we're gonna do is get all the mini kits. And of course try to get two Jedi on the missing levels. So see you guys next time.